Hello dear students, now we will discuss in our today's lecture whatever regarding coordination number 4, coordination number 5 and coordination number 6 examples. Okay, means simply we have to write hybridizations. ठीक है. Now in previous lecture we saw then regarding Werner coordination theory, okay, valence bond theory. I hope you understood that. ठीक है. Now see whatever regarding this ligands means strength of ligand we discuss. ठीक है. So here one more important part regarding these ligands. Okay, so say what will happen, whatever pairing of electrons, okay, so say you can write pairing of electrons will occur, pairing of electrons will occur against Hund's rule. So as you know, Hund's rule of maximum multiplicity, first singly failed then pairing taking place, okay, this thing you know. ठीक है. Suppose say pairing of electrons will occur against Hund's rule in the presence of strong filled ligands. So strong filled ligands, as you know, which are those strong filled ligands? Your cyanide, cobalt, okay, cyanide, your carbonyl, these are what? Yes, strong filled ligands. So we will see here example. Suppose here D subshell, okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. Okay, so how pairing of electrons will occur against Hund's rule? Means Hund's rule, they are saying electrons will failed singly then pairing taking place, but in the presence of strong field ligand what will happen? Pairing of electrons. Okay, so suppose in the presence of this CN as a strong field ligand, what will happen? Say what will happen, beta, in that D subshell as like this, so total 6 are there. Means here this electron will pair up here, this electron will pair up here, so you will get like this 4 and 5, 6. Okay, understood? Okay, so like that it is very much important. Means pairing of electrons will occur against Hund's rule, means in the presence of strong field ligand, yes, these are what, paired up. Now one more remarkable statement with this, okay, say what it is. No pairing will occur in the presence of weak field ligand. No pairing of electrons, no pairing of electrons will occur in the presence of what? Weak filled ligands. ठीक है. In the presence of weak filled ligands. Now see here beta, here these two things you must know. Suppose for example, suppose if you took here above example as like this, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. So suppose here Cl- is there. So Cl- is what? Wakefield ligand. So in the presence of Cl- as a Wakefield ligand, what will happen? These electrons will remain as it is. Okay, this electron will remain as it is. There is a no pairing because of this what? Wakefield ligand does not have that much tendency to pair up electrons. Okay, understood? Okay, so it is one of the most important remarkable statements regarding your weak field and strong field ligands. Now on the basis of this, we have to write hybridization according to VBT, valence bond theory. We have to write hybridization, their magnetic property, okay? Thereafter magnetic movement also. Now we will start. So write down analysis of complex compounds on the basis of VBT. Yes, see here, analysis of complex compounds, analysis of complex compounds on the basis of VBT. Okay, very much important part is, okay, so we have to take first example with you can write coordination. We have to discuss example with coordination number 4. Okay, coordination number 4. So ready with this coordination number 4. Okay, so concentrate. First we will take here example. First example, NiCO4. These are what? NiCO4. So can you write the IUPAC, inorganic IUPAC name of this compound? Yes, IUPAC name is what? IUPAC name is, yes, first ligand name means, say, what beta? Tetracarbonyl. Okay, tetracarbonyl nickel 0. Why 0? Because here cobalt, sorry, on this carbonyl there is no any charge. On this carbonyl there is no any charge. Therefore nickel here oxidation number simply 0. Understood? Okay, means say once you know nickel is in 0 oxidation number. Okay, now see, after this we have to write nickel outermost electronic configuration. So before that you must know the atomic number. Yes, atomic number how much? Okay, yes, 28. As you know that mantras of our D block elements, that is Skati, Vakramana, Feko, Nikunjana. Okay, Feko, Nikunjana. So 28 atomic number, you can cross check. Okay, so here nickel 28. Now what will be the outermost electronic configuration? We want outermost electronic configuration, that is 3d8 4s2. Okay, so here simply for nickel we have to write like this 3d8, C as like this, we have to write subshell 3d8, D subshell means 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Got this? Understood. Now 4s2 as like this. So see here, it is your 3d8 and is what? 4s2. Understood. Now one thing here you have to keep in mind after writing this nickel. So as you know, nickel in zero oxidation state, so there is any change after, means say, so we wrote normal nickel here, that is 3d8 4s2. मग जेव्हा आपल्या निकेल झिरो ऑक्सिडेशन स्टेटला आहे, ठीक आहे, मग त्यावेळेला सुद्धा आपल्याला काय लिहायचं आहे, सेम 3d8 4s2 ओनली, मीन्स व्हॉट एवर, ऑर यू कॅन री राईट अगेन, नो इश्यूज, मीन्स ॲज लाईक दिस यू कॅन री राईट बेटा निकेल इन झिरो, सो सेम ओनली इट विल कम, येस ऑर नो, सेम ओनली वी हॅव टू राईट ॲज लाईक दिस, मीन्स 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8. So beta, here what? 3d8. Here what? 4s2. Okay. Now 4p we have to, at that time only you have to write here this 4p subshell. Okay, these are what beta? Empty only. 4p is what? Your empty only. Okay, understood up till this. You can rewrite or his upon continue kele tari chalel, because here nickel is in zero oxidation state only. Ma parat lihayachi garaj nahi, okay, tumhi lela, theek hai. Now we have to check, say after this we have to check here, say nickel, whatever ligand is present with respect to this central metal atom is what? Tetracarbonyl is what? Strong field ligand. So as you know, strong field ligand, it has a tendency to paired up. Okay, so how I will write here? Yes, I will write like this, nickel zero after this step. Okay, so see here, yes, it is your D subshell as like this. 3d8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay. Now what will happen? These electrons, so carefully observe here. These electrons will paired up, because whatever carbonyl is all strong field. Okay. So as like this, these electrons will paired up. Now say, okay, paired up, so this becomes your empty, means it is what, your 3D, this what here, 4S, okay, this what here, your 4S empty, and here 4P also your empty. Now we have to cross check here, whatever your 4S and your 4P, now step by step we have to keep in mind, after this, see, there is a total 4 ligand, so this will occupy your vacant orbitals. This will occupy your vacant orbital, and together means CO carbon here, total 4 are there, so it will occupy here, having same energy, equal energy as like a hybridization. So together here will form, what will be the hybridization? S and P3, 1s and P3 V2. So hybridization of your this tetracarbonyl nickel is what? SP3. What beta? SP3. Now you tell me here one thing. Okay, you got this SP3. So here very much important, that is step by step you have to keep in mind what operation I am going to discuss here, step by step. Means first one, you must know the atomic number of central metal atom. Thereafter, how much charge on that central metal atom. Thereafter, what is a ligand, weak field or strong field, and according to where to pair it up. Okay, so this operation we have to keep in mind. Okay, now suppose if you are discussing here magnetic behavior, magnetic behavior of NiCO4. Yes, what it is? See, all electrons are paired up, therefore it is diamagnetic. Therefore it is what? Diamagnetic. Pairing, all electrons are paired up, therefore it is what? Diamagnetic. Understood? I hope you understood this first hour with coordination number 4, first example, that is tetracarbonyl nickel. Very, very much important for your competitive as well as your theory written exam. So pay attention this. We have to do this all. Okay. So beta, in this coordination number 4, we will discuss here another example also. So before going to another example, sp3 money, what will be the geometry of that complex? Yes, tetrahedral, tetracarbonyl nickel, as like your methane is also a tetrahedral. Understood? Okay, so see, we discuss first with coordination number 4. Now you concentrate on this thing. We will discuss next another example having coordination number 4. Okay, so second we will take here example beta. Okay, NiCl4 2 minus. What beta? NiCl4 2 minus. So what will happen? See, first step is what? Yes, first step is our nickel atomic number, as you know, 28. So what? 3d8, 4s2, this thing you must know. Thereafter, how much charge present on this nickel in this complex? So x plus minus 4 is equal to minus 2. So obviously x is what? Plus 2. So therefore on this nickel, how much charge? Plus 2. Understood? So beta, when you are, once you know whatever nickel is in plus 2, so we will write first about your normal nickel. So normal nickel, how? See, normal nickel, you have to write like this. Yes. See, 5 subshells are there. 1, 2, D subshell over. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 3D8. Now next is what? Yes. 4H2. Okay. Your 4P is empty. 4P is empty. Now, whatever your nickel oxidation number, yes, Ni2+. So how we can write for Ni2+? For Ni2+, how we can write? See, yes, for Ni2+, these two electrons will goes out. Okay, from S subshell, now your arrangement of these orbitals becomes, say, your 3D8 as it is. 3D8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So this will empty because 2 electron minus goes out. And here what? Yes, 4P, 4S. In previous example, there is a nickel 0, so no need of any losing of electrons. Understood? Okay. So that's why there is a whatever for nickel normal, same it will continue. But here what? Your anion plus 2, therefore it will lose. Therefore this 2 electron will goes out. Okay, and here you got what? Empty. Now here what we have to discuss here next? Yes, we have to discuss, okay, your this, see next what? Your Cl. Yes, your Cl minus. Cl is what? Your Wakefield ligand. Means next step is what? We have to concentrate on this ligand. Yes, it is Wakefield ligand. So there will be any change? No? Yes. Okay. Here no pairing will takes place because Cl is what? Wakefield ligand. So you can write as a for ni 2 plus like this. Okay, this will means for again you have to rewrite this 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8. So here what? 3d8. Now here 4s is your empty and 4p also empty. So here what will happen? 4 total. Now here your vacant orbital, it will take Cl, one Cl, another Cl, this Cl and this Cl, means total 4. So beta togetherly here what will happen? Togetherly we can call it as a what? Which hybridization? 1s and p3, s p3. Got 1s and this p3. Therefore your hybridization of this tetra, so here now we can write a name also, IUPAC name. What will beta? Yes, tetrachlorido nickel. Okay, tetrachlorido nickel second ion. Tetrachlorido nickel second ion. Okay, means what will be the hybridization of this? sp3. Understood? It is what beta? sp3. Means sp3. So beta here what will be the your geometry? Yes, geometry is what? Yes, geometry is your tetrahedral. Geometry is what? Yes, tetrahedral here. Okay, I hope you understood this thing. Okay, regarding your, yes, regarding what? Regarding hybridization, geometry, then what will be the magnetic movement beta here? Yes, what will be the magnetic movement? Magnetic movement also you can calculate magnetic behavior also. Suppose if you are thinking about, say if you are thinking about magnetic behavior, so magnetic behavior, yes, it depends on number of paired or unpaired electrons. Yes, here unpaired electrons. So paired unpaired electrons means what? Paramagnetic. Okay, and magnetic movement, magnetic movement having formula mu is equal to under root n n plus 2 number of unpaired electrons, where n is what? Where n is your number of unpaired electrons, so total 2 are there. So 2 plus 2 you can solve easily. Okay, so it is, that is your answer in BM, Bohr magnetism. I know you can solve this calculation part easily. Okay, understood? So here these are what our example regarding, yes, regarding what? AnionCl4, yes, AnionCl4 2
माइनस, ठीक है, सी हियर वी विल डिस्कस नेक्स्ट ऑल्सो. ओके सो राइट डाउन हियर नेक्स्ट. सो वी कैन सॉल्व हियर इजीली. सो सी 2 + 2 = 4. सो व्हाट अंडर रूट 8. सो रूट 8. ओके सो रूट 8 एज यू नो व्हाट विल बी द रूट 8 एंड दैट इज योर कैलकुलेशन इज व्हाट बोहर मैग्नेट आर्म. अंडरस्टूड. इट इज अ यूनिट. सो नेक्स्ट वी विल डिस्कस हियर नेक्स्ट कॉम्प्लेक्स हैविंग कोऑर्डिनेशन नंबर 4. ठीक है. सो नेक्स्ट वी विल डिस्कस हियर. सी having coordination number 4. So write down that third one. Say NiCN4 2 minus, okay, NiCN4 2 minus. Okay, so as you know, first you have to write atomic number, then what electronic configuration. Okay, thereafter nickelin normal state you have to write for D and S subshell, P subshell empty. Okay, so see as like this. And we have to, most important word, you have to calculate oxidation number of this nickel. So X plus minus 4 is equal to what? Minus 2. Therefore X is equal to what? Plus 2. Means nickel is in what? Plus 2. So first we will write for about normal nickel. Okay, so normal nickel is what? As like this, 3d8 4s2. As you know about normal nickel, 3d8 4s2 outermost electronic configuration as like this. 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 and 8. Okay, these are what your 3D subshell. Now this what 4s, 2 1 2, and your 4p you can write as a empty 4p subshell. Okay, now what Ni2+, so what will happen? Yes, this electron will goes out. Okay, so you can write like this. 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8. These electrons will goes out, these two electrons. So 4 is your empty, here 3d8, here what 4p your empty. Now we have to concentrate on this ligand. So beta cyanide CN minus is what? SFL, that is strong field ligand. So it has a tendency to pair up. Therefore your, what will happen? Yes, see, these electrons will pair up. So we can rewrite again this, how it will pair up as like this. Okay, so say 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8, how it will pair up? Because strong field ligand. Now these also your empty, you have to mention. Okay, empty asle tari pan te lihaycha ahe, because finally we have to show what hybridization. Understood? Theek hai. So see here. Yes, once you know your cyanide is what? Strong field. So it has a tendency to pair up. Now what? Your ligand will take vacant orbitals. So see as like this. Starting with this, because it is empty, they got 1 CN. Here cyanide 2 3, and here also 4. So kul mila ke what will be the hybridization you got? Yes, you got the hybridization D S P2. Yes, understood? What you got? D
is P2 because we utilize, we have these four ligands only, so that much only position we will occupy, understood? So therefore here DS1 is P2 because we have four only ligands, understood? ठीक है. Now see how there we can write as a geometry also. See as like this CN ठीक है. Square planar.
What beta? Square planar.
Now suppose if we discuss here magnetic,
what?
Yes, magnetic behavior. So what will be the magnetic behavior? Magnetic behavior is what? All are paired, therefore what? Diamagnetic.
I hope you understood the magnetic behavior also. Okay. So like that it is very much simple. Okay. So you have to keep in mind whatever hybridization with what? With your coordination number 4. ठीक है. सो एज अ होमवर्क यू कैन ड्रॉ वॉट एवर आई एम सेइंग हियर. ठीक है. 4th and 5th
यू लीव सम स्पेस फॉर दैट.
ओके सो राइट बेटा
मीन्स ए 4th you have to do Cu Cl4 2 minus, can you do this? And 5th one you have to do this Pt Cn4 2 minus
you can, but here you must know the charge present on center metal atom
as well as what will be, okay, with the electronic configuration also, outermost electron configuration for your copper and for this Pt. Okay,
so with the help of this you can easily miss same steps you have to use up till that whatever we use for generating hybridization, then magnetic behavior, magnetic movement, okay, geometry. ठीक है. सो यू हैव टू कीप इन माइंड दिस सिंपल स्टेप्स. ठीक है. नाउ हियर वी विल डिस्कस वन ऑफ दी एक्सेप्शनल केस. सी वन ऑफ दी बेटा एक्सेप्शनल केस वी विल डिस्कस हियर. Pay attention on that exceptional case of hybridization.
I write down,
yes,
exceptional case of hybridization. ठीक है.
Exceptional case of hybridization. So see here, that is hybridization is what? SP2D. Hybridization is what beta? SP2D. Now that complex here, what will be that complex? CuNH3 4 and 2+. CuNH3 4 2+. Suppose why it is exceptional, that we will see. ठीक है. सपोज इफ यू विल डू दिस नॉर्मली ऑन द बेस ऑफ नॉर्मल बेस्ड, सी
copper is, as you know, what will be the charge on this copper here? S2+. And as you know, copper spati vakraman fekoni kunjana. So 29 atomic number. So here what? Yes,
3d10. Okay,
3d10 and 4s1 modified outermost electronic configuration. Keep in mind, modified outermost electronic configuration. 3d10, 4s1. Okay, so here, as you know, copper, what, x is equal to plus 2 because it is a zero. There is no charge on this ammonia. So copper beta here, 3d10, as like this, 2, 3, 4, 5. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So here what beta? 3d10. Here what? Yes, 4s1. One only, and 4p is what? Empty. We can mention here 4d also. Okay, 4d subshell as empty. Now suppose if you are thinking regarding your ammonia, yes, ammonia here what? Now see, before that we have to write for Cu2+ also. First we have to write for Cu2+. So carefully we have to follow these steps. Okay, it is very much important to follow these steps. Okay. So beta 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Now what will happen, say whenever Cu2+, so this 2+ electron goes out, one this and one this. So you will get what here? Yes, 3d9 and 4s0. So here also 4s is also your empty. 4p already empty, and 4d also, it is already empty. Take a. Now on the base of this, what will be the your hybridization? Yes, these are what? Ammonia here is what? Strong field ligand. So these electron can't paired up. Okay, pairing will not occur, because these are what? There is no any space here. Understood? So here hybridization is what? Total 4 are there. So one here ammonia, vacant orbital, they will take your ammonia as like this. So sp3 hybridization becomes, okay, sp3 hybridization. But experimentally it is not sp3, it is what? sp2d. Means sp2d, it is not what? Tetrahedral. Suppose if you are going through like this, it is not a tetrahedral, it is what? A square planar. Okay, so again they will done, suppose we will try to achieve this. First DSP2, so DSP2 has also a new square planar. Okay, so see what will happen here. Okay, now what they done? Okay, here also we will I will show here. See, now as you know here for copper, yes, for this Cu2+. Okay, for this Cu2+, we will write, because whatever experiment, finally we have to conclude hybridization in this step only, correct? So we will directly write that again, rewrite again. So see here, these what? 3d9, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, yes, 6, 7, 8, 9. Here what? Your 4s is empty. 4p also empty, and here what? Yes, here 4d. okay, 4D. Now what will happen? Say in this 4D means one of the electron will jump from 3D subshell, means from this 3D subshell to 4D, sorry, 3D subshell to what? 4P subshell, means here. So obviously when one of the electron will jump from this 3D subshell to 4P subshell, so what will happen? This electron can be easily removed. Whatever that single electrons, whatever jump electron, we can easily remove that. Then Cu2 plus is converted into what? Cu3 plus. Okay, Cu2 plus is converted into Cu3 plus. But that Cu3 plus which is not existed, never. Means copper most common oxidation number is what? Cu2 plus. And somewhere Cu plus, but it is red. And that Cu plus one also, it is unstable in aqueous solution. Okay. So here, whatever we are thinking, then here we can call it as a here, say DSP2. Okay, here they are combining. Okay, here it will form as like this DSP2. D1, DS and P2 means here square planar, but what they are saying, SP2D hybridization. So to explain this, it is square planar geometry. Okay, so one scientist having name is Huggins. Okay, Huggins proposed SP2D hybridization. Huggins proposed SP2D hybridization. So how it is SP2D hybridization? So see, as like this, I will show you here Cu2 plus. Okay, Cu2 plus here. So as you know, total here three days of shell, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9, 3D 9, yes, for this. Now as you know, yes, here your 4S, take a, here what beta, 4P, and here what, yes, 4D, 4D money 5 subshell, D money 5 subshell. Okay, so see what will happen. Huggins proposed SP2D hybridization. How? See what he done. He done as like this, means this total is P2 and D. Is P2 and this. SP2 and D this. Means SP2 and D like this. Okay, what SP2D hybridization, who proposed? Huggins. So these are what exceptional case regarding your what CuNH3O2 plus, understood? So finally becomes your SP2D hybridization. It is what? Paramagnetic in nature. Okay, now beta, here we will discuss, see, we will discuss example of coordination number 5. Okay, we will discuss here, see, I hope you understood this exceptional case also, very much interesting. First sp3 येत होतं, त्याच्यानंतर काय झालं, डी एस पी टू आलं, बट अगेन्स प्रपोज हाऊ डी एस पी टू डी स्क्वेअर प्लॅनर. ओके, नाऊ सी विथ कोऑर्डिनेशन नंबर 4. सेकंड वी विल डिस्कस युअर सेकंड टाईप, दॅट इज कोऑर्डिनेशन नंबर 5.
कोऑर्डिनेशन नंबर 5 वी विल डिस्कस हियर वन एग्जांपल. ठीक है, सो सी हियर हाउ वी कैन डिस्कस हियर रिगार्डिंग योर यस कोऑर्डिनेशन नंबर 5 FECO5. What will be the IUPAC name? Yes, IUPAC name is what? Yes, pentacarbonyl iron. Pentacarbonyl iron 0. Pentacarbonyl iron 0. Understood? See how we can draw here. So here you must know iron. Iron is what? 26. So beta 3d6 4s2 outermost electronic configuration. Okay. Now say, as you know, we have to generate, we have to calculate oxidation number also. Okay, so how much? Here 0, because carbonyl, there is no charge, therefore your iron is what? 0. 0 only. So iron, like that, you can normal, for normal iron, 3d6, as like this, 3d6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6, 4s2, 4H2 as like this, 4P you are empty, okay, and here what? We can show here as a 4D also empty, no issues. Okay, now see, for iron 0, same only, because no any changes. But again you can rewrite like this, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 3d6, here what beta 4h2, here what 4p is empty, you can mention or no initials, okay, 3d6, 4h2, now it's time to discuss what, yes. Whether our carbon is strong field or weak field, yes, as you know, carbonyl is what? Strong field ligand. So beta strong field ligand, therefore pairing will occur, yes or no? These electrons will go here, this electron means total are there, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, so it will paired up. So how it will pair, see, as like this, pairing of this Fe0 oxidation number 0, as like this we can rewrite again like this. So see, one electron here, and then these two also will come in D. So 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8, so see, total 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Yes, total S. So these are what? Beta 3d6. No, okay. We can, no need to mention here whatever electrons. 3d subshell. Here what? 4s is now empty. Here 4p also what? Your empty. Okay. Now it's time to what? Draw whatever next work is what? Carbonyl means strong field ligand. Whatever strong field ligand work is over, electrons will pair up. Okay. Now we have to occupy vacant hybrid orbitals carbonyl will take. So one carbonyl, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. So you will get hybridization is what? Kul mila ke hybridization kya hua? DSP3. What beta? DSP3. Understood. DSP3. Okay, and it is what? Trigonal bipyramidal geometry.
Trigonal bipyramidal geometry. So as you know, as like this, your this iron, your cobalt, sorry, carbonyl. Okay, as like this. ठीक है, पेंटाकार्बोनिल व्हाट? आयरन जीरो. पेंटाकार्बोनिल आयरन जीरो. सो ट्राइगोनल बाय पिरामिडल DSP3 यू गॉट हियर. ठीक है,
आई होप यू अंडरस्टूड दिस थिंग. Okay, so here DSP3 you got. Now what about magnetic behavior?
Magnetic behavior, yes, here all are paired up means what? Diamagnetic. You have to write.
Okay,
what beta? Diamagnetic. Okay,
I hope you understood this thing regarding your magnetic behavior also. Okay,
now whatever regarding your coordination number 6 examples, we will discuss in next lecture. Thank you very much and take care.